Chris Mayle at BBTV. We're at Yui Fiori's gym, and with Yui Fiori, how are you doing, mate?
Yeah, not too bad.
Hard session, sparring night tonight. One in, one out. You're the one who's in there all the time, by the looks of it.
Yeah, that's true. It's always that case. I always have it tough with that. It's all just getting back into the rhythm of things, working on new things. Like always, you can never stop learning in this game, and you can't. We always change up as well. You're not doing the same thing.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, to come off that fight with Hammer, I'm sure you was waiting to load that hammer up to get him out of there, but he ended up pulling out with that shoulder injury. You got the rounds on your belt, though. Again, it's another good name on your record, but was you frustrated ultimately, like you didn't get him out of there cleanly?
Yeah, the plan was, it was all like smoothing out nicely in the fight. The fifth round, that's where the shots was majorly getting into him. He was starting to get hit clean, and I could see he was failing. And he was doing like little things to get a point took off him and stuff like that. There are signs he wanted out of there.
Yeah.
You could see he wanted out as soon as he's never been hit so many times in his life in one round. And that's why he knew what was going to happen. I would have given it one to two more rounds and it would have been a clean knockout. But obviously, got a bit robbed of that, but
yeah.
It's one of them.
Yeah.
You just got to do what you got to do in there. He was working on to later rounds, that was the game plan. But funny enough, in that fight, I said to my dad before the fight, I said, he's going to quit. I said, that was before the fight, I said, I don't think he'll continue. I think in the later rounds, I think he'll jack his corner.
You thought that anyway, yeah.
I said, my dad will tell you the words. Yeah. He said, what do you reckon is going to happen with this fight? And I said, truthfully, I reckon he's going to retire in his corner.
Right. So you could feel it. But when he's landing some good shots inside, you could see, him fading.
He was fading. As soon as. Like you say, he was egging him on, talking to him in there, and you could see he was getting disheartened. And as the fight was going on, that was the plan. It was to get him in that later stage of the fight, and then as soon as that happened, he obviously never got there.
Yeah. But looking back on it, you can only look at the time you was in there, and you look good, you looked happy to be in there, which is the main thing. You know, it was a good platform, wasn't it? A good audience, great crowd and all that up there in Newcastle. But you looked happy to be in there and you looked comfortable as well. And
yeah,
like you was working on things that you had been.
Very comfortable in there, very easy. And this is what I'm saying now, it's my time. And each fight now is just improving. And people's not even seeing the best of me yet. It's just, we keep going all the time.
Do you know what is good as well? Like you've stepped out of that ring and you know you're not a good, you've got another fight coming up. You don't have to worry about getting in the gym and waiting for a phone call, waiting for a date.
No,
you know, you're on this Sky deal now.
It's like set dates. Before, it was just like, as you've seen in Southwest, was always in the gym waiting for fights and that to come and the training and not training, but always kicking on. It was hard work.
Yeah.
And now the fights are here and over the moon.
Yeah, it's brilliant. Yeah, yeah. But, December 11th, is it? You're back
11th,
out then, yeah. So looking at opponents, have you been given a list again, that same old scenario, or are you just waiting on someone to be confirmed?
I'm not too sure yet, just hopefully in the next week or so, should be all confirmed.
You'll get a name. And again, another world-ranked opponent and someone who's going to get you a step further for a world
100%.
Title.
That's the way we want to be and get to the top. Me, Chris, don't care who it is, we're just getting there and fight.
We all know that, you'll get in with anyone, yeah.
No, the only thing is just get to that top and where we want to be.
Yeah, and the heavyweight division, it's always all over, but it almost feels like it's coming to that, you know, every time there's a changeover, fighters come to the end and there's a new bunch that come through. You're almost at the tail end of the old bunch, but almost like the new generation again, if you like. So, you know, you've got a lot of years left in you, and it's going to get very interesting the way the heavyweight division pans out, isn't it, over the next few years?
100%, the heavyweight division is it's wide open, and it is just getting very interesting. It's always the battles that get swapped back and forwards, and... I'm just looking forward now to taking my part in there.
Looking forward to seeing you back in there again, mate, and what the future holds.
Thank you very much.
We'll catch up again soon. God bless you.